Cordwell Children we set up 15 years ago, and the whole purpose was to help children who are in desperate medical need to lead, to be either cured or lead a much, much better life. And we help the very children that can't get help anywhere else, that can't, they're really struggling to find a better life. The health service can't help them, there's no help. And we step in to make their lives as better, you know, improve them as much as we possibly can.
Of course, I mean, 770,000 disabled children in the UK, 400,000 of those living in or around the poverty line. Do you think that just illustrates just how vital it is that these support services are there, however they get there?
Absolutely. There's hundreds of thousands, as you say, that are absolutely unable to help themselves. It only surprises me, actually, that we haven't got a lot more applicants for help, because we are there to help. We would need to raise more money, of course, if they all applied, because we'd sink under the strain. But we do spend as much time trying to find out, trying to let children know and the parents know that we are here to help them. So it's a joint thing, really. It's public awareness so that their children know we're available for help. And then, of course, the fundraising is a separate issue to try and ensure that we are able to provide that help.
In terms of the help, can you just talk us through the services that Cordwell provide?
Oh, the services are endless, from life-changing operations in America to wheelchairs like you've seen here with Tilly. You know, and a wheelchair like that completely transforms a child's life. And if you were to ask Tilly's mum, as I've just asked, what she was like without the wheelchair, it's very, very poignant to her, because there's occasions now when she has to give a wheelchair up when she goes into hospital for special treatments. And she becomes insecure, emotionally insecure, and really a completely different person. When she gets back into that wheelchair, her life's liberated. She becomes confident and glamorous and able to live, you know, as near a proper life as possible.
Of course, tonight is the Butterfly Ball, the 14th year, I think, of the event, and the 7th year in London, I believe. Can you talk a little bit about what's in store tonight and how important this event in particular is?
Well, this year we're very, very excited. We've got a phenomenal lineup of stars. We have Kylie, Peter Andre, Next of Kin, Alfie Bowe, Jake Shears doing the after show party. We've got nearly 800 guests. We've got some very, very wealthy, very important people. And we're really hoping this year makes a quantum breakthrough in the PR side to make us more known, and also in the fundraising activity.
My final question, if people want more information, where can they go?
Oh, well, the Cordwell website, the Cordwell Kids website, all the information is there. There's so many easy ways of getting hold of us. It's no problem. Just go into Google.
Why is this such an extraordinary, important cause to support?
I've been an ambassador for Cordwell Children for about 5 years now. And what I'm going to say tonight is that this is the glitz and the glamour, and it's beautiful and it's fantastic. But when you scratch beneath the surface and you see what's behind it and where that money goes and what they actually do, it is incredible. And you have to see it to believe it. You go and visit some of the centres that they've helped, some of the children that have got these unbelievable wheelchairs that they can stand up. I mean, it's incredible.
Is there one particular story, one particular person you've met through Cornwall that's really inspired you and meant a lot to you?
A lot of them have, but Tilly, I talk about Tilly because Tilly, I see her every year and she's just blossoming into this wonderful young lady. And today she pressed a button and she came right up with a wheelchair, and I was like, whoa, you know, I mean, I'm so proud. And you know, it gives them the confidence, so then they feel better and that helps them get better.
My final question before we let you go tonight. Obviously, big night. I think we just had our official launch for that. What can fans expect from that? When we get to hear the rest of it?
Blues, swing, jazz, and rock and roll. And I'm doing something that I probably should have done years ago. But it's what I love, and it's going to really help the tour. So I hope you guys like it. It's all live. The whole album's live.
Why has it taken you so long to get to this point? And what are you most proud of now that you have done it?
You know what it is? It took me to turn 40 to realize that I've got to stop wearing the gimmicky outfits, stop dancing around on stage, and actually stand there and do what I grew up loving. And you know what? It's a long process. It's not going to overnight. You know, I'm not going to break down the barriers in the music industry, but I'm doing what I love doing, and that's what's important.
absolutely fantastic to have you here tonight. What makes this such an extraordinarily important and vital cause?
The importance of the children is very close to me. I'm thrilled to be here to be supporting such a wonderful charity. It's a great establishment, and what they do for the kids is just wonderful. I mean, I've met a few of them earlier on, and they're beautiful children, and it's a pleasure to be stood on that stage this evening doing what I can do for them.
What have you got in store for us? A couple of songs tonight?
Yeah, I'm doing about four numbers. I go on first to do O Sole Mio. Then I come back on an hour later to do, obviously, Bring Him Home from Les Miserables. And two tracks off my new album, Serenata, which is going to be out in September.
Can you tell us anything about the new album? I mean, what can we expect from it overall?
The sound of the album is basically Neapolitan music. It's Italian Italian folk songs. So I'm thrilled. It's I thoroughly enjoyed recording it. The band that I recorded with were wonderful to work with. It's a band I go on tour with, so being able to tour and record with the same musicians is a blessing for me.
What is it about the Neapolitan music that particularly inspired you this time?
It's music that I love. It's music that I've been studying and singing for many years. It's lovely to be able to do it the way that I've always wanted to do it, with a band, you know, not with full orchestra. We do have strings on there, but it's they're minimalist, and it's mainly just natural production of the songs, really, you know, instinctive and beautiful.
You have a message for fans just before you leave us?
Yep. Album's out in September. Go out and buy it. It's called Serenata, and please support this charity too, please.
It's absolutely fantastic to have you here tonight at the Butterfly Ball. I guess the most obvious question, why is this such an important cause to support, and what made you personally want to come along and get involved?
Because it's to do with children, anything to do with children, and I want to be a part of it. So I like to put smiles on kids' faces, and I've been doing quite a lot of that recently. So, and it's quite a nice, feeling to have, to make a difference. So,
of course, I mean, Caldwell Children does an incredible amount of work. 770,000 families with disabled children helped by their support services. Why do you think it's particularly vital that we help give those families as much help as we can?
I've got friends that have got severely disabled children, and if I can make a difference personally to them, I'm doing the right thing, you know. And to see people come together in a great way to make a difference, it's worth doing, you know. I mean, the only thing is I have to wear a dress, and I don't really do dresses. I hate it, but I'm here. I'm making an effort in some way, shape or form, and I'm going to try and raise some money tonight and have a go at the auction. I seem to be quite good at winning things on auction, so.
Wishing you luck for that. Now, obviously, talking about children, you're looking radiant tonight. When are you due, and is it boy or girl yet? Do you know?
It's a girl, and I'm due on the 1st of October, so I'm going to be having a little girl, but I'm prone to having early babies, so I've got to take it easy about a month to 6 weeks before, so I don't want it popping out on stage, definitely not, that's not going to happen. The tour has been moved to January. As far as I'm aware, it's selling quite well, and it's going to be amazing to go some of the places that I went to on the X Factor tour. With regards to a second album, I'm just enjoying hot time with my family at the minute, and I've still got an album that's in the chart, so I don't really want to think about that just yet. But yeah, there's plenty of stuff I want to get involved in and do, but I'm just concentrating on kids and being pregnant at the minute, not trying to do too much.
Have you got a name in mind?
I have, but I'm keeping that well under wraps because I don't want anybody to know the names yet. So yeah, we've already got a name, and people will find out the name when the time comes.
Of course, I mean, apart from the obvious big change in your life, it's been an extraordinary last 12 months for you. I mean, for you, what's been the absolute highlight, apart from the obvious?
The absolute highlight for me has got to be meeting Celine Dion and Michael Bolton. Not winning the actual competition was an honour, and it's still kind of weird. And I sometimes forget when I go up the supermarket and sort of think, crap, I just won an X Factor and I've made history. And, you know, but people could forget about you next week, so I'm just trying to concentrate on making stories stay about and working hard and doing what I do best, and that's just entertaining people.
finally, do you have a message to fans before you leave, as people who wish you all the best at the moment and can't wait for more performances and more music from you as well?
I will see you all soon on the tour. Make sure you get tickets. And if anyone's got any suggestions for any songs or anything like that, or ideas or things they want me to do, chuck them my way, because this is my thinking time now. So,
why is this such an important cause to support?
Do you know what? It's just such an amazing charity. They do so much for children, and let's be fair, like, your heart goes out to children and stuff, doesn't it? So yeah, just, it's like an honour to be here. We do support the charity and they just do such amazing work. What this charity does is just unbelievable for all those families, and as I say, like, it's amazing to be such a big part of it, you know?
When you're not here supporting wonderful causes tonight, what's coming up for you at the moment? What's keeping you busy these days?
We're filming Towie Marbella soon. And to be fair, do you know what? I've just taken a bit of time out. I had a really stressful year, end of last year, the beginning of this year. And do you know what? It's just been nice for me just to take a bit of time out, find myself again, and loving life. I'm YOLOing it.
Of course, I mean, like you say, it's been a busy and stressful last 12 months. For you, what's been the toughest moment? What's been the best moment?
I think, you know, obviously everyone knows I was engaged to be married this, like, last year, and, you know, I think coming out of that and realising that I didn't really want to get married. I wanted to get married my whole life, but when it comes to it, I knew I did and it weren't the right person. So that was, you know, it was a stressful time for me, but everything's amazing now, and, you know, just see what happens. You never know. Every day is really exciting for me and meeting lots of new people. So just wait and see what happens.
Are you looking forward to getting out in Marbella then for the special?
Cannot wait for Marbs. I am so excited. Yeah, I can't wait, literally. Towie's never ever going to end. I think everyone loves Towie and it's everyone's guilty pleasure. So for me, you know, Towie will go on forever and a day. People love it.
What makes this such an extraordinarily important cause to support?
Do you know what? I do so much work for Caldwell Children. Obviously, my really good friends are John and Claire. The children, me going, you know, seeing the children like so ill, and you just can't believe how lucky you are. And you know, and I make all, you know, we make these people's days. Like, all the celebrity team going to sit with them and spend time with them. And a few of the Caldwell Children have come down to my salon and spent time with me. So it's a great charity to be part of, and I do a lot for them, as I said.
You say you work a lot with these extraordinary children. Is there a particular story that you could share with us, really, that touched you, a moment where you've really felt inspired or moved by what Caldwell does?
Do you know what? I think Caldwell is just an amazing charity, like, all in all. All their stories are amazing. I can't actually think of one that I've just, but they all take me away. And yeah, it's great to be here tonight. So I'll be sure I'll be seeing the amazing children and sit with them tonight. Do you know what, this is a great thing about, you know, being, like, doing the fame industry, because, you know, you meet such amazing people. I do so much for charity. I ran the marathon last year for the British Heart Foundation. Hopefully I'm going to be doing the marathon next year for the Caldwell Children. So it's all about raising loads of money and spending time with amazing children.
Lately, of course, I think your comments on plastic surgery have really meant a lot to a lot of people, and I think opening up like that's quite a brave thing to do. Can you just talk about what made you want to share that?
I just think, you know, young girls think it's really easy now to have cosmetic surgery and they just rush into it. I just want to, just, you know, share to these girls out there that it's quite hard to, to just go and have cosmetic surgery done. And with me, you know, I rushed into it and I've had a bit of a backlash now. So I just want to share it with all my friends.